In this project, we have 5 screens that we can jump to with these screen change buttons. If we click on a normal screen like screen 3, we go right to it. If we click on a password protected screen like screen 2, we're challenged to enter a password to get access. The password for screen 2 is 4 twos. Click enter, and it lets us in. If we go to a screen that requires a password, let's go to screen 1, that's password protected, and we type the wrong password, we get an error and we're prompted to try again. Here's how you set that up. Go to the password menu from the Navigation Windows Function tab under Configure Password, or under the Setup menu, Configure Password. You can create up to 8 groups, each with their own password. In this case, we have managers, engineers, and supervisors set up with their own password. You're allowed passwords of up to 20 characters max, but they have to be numeric. You can't use letters. Also, be sure to specify how the password will be entered. If you're using a touchscreen, then this option 1 down here is great. If not, then option 2 will bring up a little soft menu so you can use the function keys, or option 3 right here lets you use the keypad bezel for password entry, if you have one installed. We have a touchscreen, so we'll choose option 1. Once your passwords are all set, hit OK. Given the password groups that we just created, now we just have to assign those to the screens to limit the access. Let's allow all 3 groups to go to screen 1. So we bring up our screen menu, right-click on screen 1, choose Screen Option, and go to the Password tab. Here we simply put a check mark next to any group that we want to have access to this screen. Or we can enable everybody. Let's save that one. On screen 2, right-click, Screen Options, Password tab, we're going to enable the password protection, but only give the engineers access to this screen. And finally, screen 5, right-click, Screen Options, Password, we're only going to let the supervisors have access to that screen. So again, we simply enable the password option, click on Supervisors, and hit OK. Let's bring that up in the simulator and see how it works. So remember, screens 3 and 4 were not protected, and sure enough, we can go straight to those. Screen 1 was open access to all 3 groups, so any of the 3 passwords will work here. Let's go to screen 1, and let's try the manager's password, which was 4 ones. And it gives us access to the screen. Now screen 2 only allowed access to the engineers with password 2222. So if we type anything else, we get our error message. Finally, screen 5 only had access for the supervisors, which was 4 nines. So everything's working exactly as we expect. One side note, notice that in your project, screens that are password protected have a little P down in the lower right corner. So on our project, screen 1, 2, and 5 are password protected. Well, that's all there is to password protecting screens. Be sure to check out the other videos in this series. And as always, please send us any topics you would like to see covered, or any other comments for that matter. We appreciate the feedback.